Ken Feinberg may be causing the biggest headaches at Citigroup, AIG, and Bank of America this morning. But pay is not the only hurdle these companies need to clear. They still owe the government billions of dollars in TARP money and stock warrants. Here to tell us whether taxpayers are getting their money's worth from the TARP is Cornell University professor Robert Jarrow. He's with us from the Cornell campus in Ithaca, New York this morning. Bob, very good of you to join us. Let us talk about the valuations on these warrants. It has been among the most controversial aspects of the TARP program. You were retained by the Treasury Department to provide an independent analysis. What's your conclusion?
I think that taxpayers are getting fair value, absolutely.
Okay, well, explain that, because there are a lot of people, including the Congressional Oversight Panel, who would disagree with that. The Congressional Oversight Panel says, in fact, that these banks were able to buy back the warrants at only 66% of their real value.
Right. Well, so these warrants are very illiquid. And the best way to come up with a value is to either get an independent quote from a market participant or a consultant, or mark to model. You need a financial model to value the warrants.
Okay, but we've heard so much about financial models going wrong, that financial models were the reason that we got into the credit crisis in the first place, because they didn't accurately predict what was going to happen to subprime mortgages. Why is the model that you're using to value these warrants and ultimately to determine whether the taxpayer is getting his money's worth one that's worth relying on?
Right. So first of all, it's not the models that caused the problems. It was the use of poor models. And I think of models as if they were prescription drugs. As long as they're used properly, they improve the health of the client or the user. Same with models. If they're used properly, they do improve the financial health of the institution. So good models used properly provide proper valuation.
So in your opinion, the Treasury Department is using good models in this case?
Correct. And the Congressional Oversight Panel's analysis was a flawed model.
Okay, let us talk about another big issue this morning. It's the whole effort by the Fed, by Ken Feinberg, the PAYSAR, to crack down on risk-taking, irresponsible, excessive risk-taking, by setting compensation limits and changing the way that pay is handed out to bankers on Wall Street, introducing things like clawbacks. Do you believe, because you're an expert on risk, that ultimately this is going to have the desired effect, that the banking system is going to be stronger and safer as a result?
Yes, I also believe that's a proper approach, because you want to make executive compensation long-term oriented and not short-term and focus.
Okay, but in principle, people argue with the idea that the government should be setting compensation limits. From a risk management standpoint, is that the right way to go, or do you favor this sort of more favor the clawback approach, taking money back over the long term if the profits just don't last?
Well, I'm not sure whether or not it's better to do the clawback or make the payment structure long-term in receipt through the stock options.
All right. Dr. Jarrow, thank you very much. That is Professor Robert Jarrow of Cornell University talking to us about the valuations of TARP warrants and, of course, the big story of the day, Ken Feinberg and the Fed cracking down on Wall Street pay.